do belong here. You are important. We do support you, and we want you to be the best homemaker that you can possibly be. Welcome back to the channel, lovely feminine women. Thank you so much for being here. Your support and your love on my previous few videos has overwhelmed me, and I'm so happy that the content that I'm making is truly connecting with you, because that is my goal on this channel, to make videos that speak to you so that we can grow as a sisterhood and so that we can present to the world the topics and the issues that are important to us. I love getting new faces on this channel, and I just wanted to do a little shout out to my friend Felicia from The Feminine Fancy, who has reached 100K on her channel. And in one of her previous videos, she mentioned me and to check out my channel. So if you are here from her, I wanted to say thank you so much. And if you aren't yet subscribed to her, you should, because she puts out some of the best femininity content on the internet. You can hit the lovely red subscribe button to join the femininity revolution, because on this channel, we believe in pushing forward the cultural conversation to include us, the section of the population that likes to express our femininity and perhaps has a little bit more of traditional values, as such as homemaking. Today we're going to answer the question, can you find value as a childless housewife, as a childless homemaker? And if you couldn't guess by now, my answer is yes. But this was really inspired from a few messages that I got on Instagram from some of you talking about how you feel a sense of societal shame and criticism for being a childless homemaker. Of course, our fellow stay-at-home moms, many of you are who watch this channel, do face similar criticism, but there is an added burden, an added stress from being a childless homemaker. For many of us, it just means that perhaps we cannot have children, or we choose not to have children. Or you might be in the same boat as me on a trying to conceive journey that is just taking a little bit more time. So how do you find value as a childless homemaker? The first thing I want to talk about concerns critics. Now, a lot of people, if you live a different type of lifestyle, are going to have criticism towards you simply because you stick out like a sore thumb in society. And if you aren't a stay-at-home mom and you are a childless homemaker, the red flags in their mind tend to go off, because people have this image that you might be abused, or you might be a lazy leech or a gold digger. And to those people, I have to say, it's really a shame that they live their life being critical of others. When we look at other people, we shouldn't criticize them at first glance without knowing their whole entire story. So you can find solace in the fact that these people do not know you, they do not know your intention, and they do not know your dynamic. A lot of times people compare their life to yours. I often hear many people who are critical of housewives without children talking about how they don't understand how they aren't bored the whole entire day, but that is because they have this preconceived notion about their life and how they wouldn't have a lot of things to do every single day if they were to choose that life path. So of course, for them, it isn't something that they would like to do. But for me, and probably for you, there is a variety of things that I do every single day. I help my husband. I am a type A personality with an extensive cleaning list. I have personal projects and side hobbies. There's also this unseen element that many of you have told me you struggle with, which might be health reasons or mental health dilemmas, and you can't always show the world those things at first glance. So when those people criticize you, they aren't taking into account that you might have so many things that are hidden, personal burdens, your cross to bear. It is human psychology to want to win other people over to our side. That's why I think that the whole world is fueled with drama right now and separation, because we all want to prove to another person that we are correct. Part of it is the fact that we, of course, want to show how joyful we are for our beliefs. But for some people who are extra critical, it might extend to the point that it is a pride issue. You can find solace in remembering those things, and also the fact that now we have gone to a little bit of flipping the script in comparison to a time like the 1950s. It was more common for women to stay home after they got married, even if they were childless. Compared to now, it is very uncommon for people to stay home at all beyond like the 1 year of maternity leave. So there's this subconscious kind of like where a lot of people equate progressing to complete rejection of values that are more traditional but might suit your dynamic. There's a perfect storm of all of the reasons why, and I talked about in my Q&A that I will eventually make a video on this topic, that caused for me to be a homemaker, to have a busy schedule, to feel the most fulfilled, to feel the most stable, and have the best marriage that I can possibly have for my personal dynamic, that resulted in me seeking a stay-at-home lifestyle. This might be the same thing for you as a childless homemaker, as a childless housewife. So that being said, I want you to rest in the fact that those people just don't know. And like I mentioned in my previous Q&A, if you haven't watched it yet, I'm going to link it down below as well as above. We can't exactly fight fire with fire in all circumstances, especially when it is deduced down to a lifestyle belief, to the core beliefs of somebody's personality. So to convince other people of your lifestyle, the most effective thing to do is to use the tactics I talked about in my criticism and judgment video. I will also link it above as well as down below, but to lead with it through example and to build your confidence, which is going to bring me to the next part of this video. I'm going to give you some tools to build your confidence and find more purpose as a childless housewife. I want you to continue to cultivate your why. I have mentioned this in countless homemaking videos that I have made throughout the past 2 years. You need to understand your reason why and reassure yourself of how that works for your mental health as well as your relationship. For me, I get incredibly invested in any project that I take on, hence this YouTube channel. So staying home aligned perfectly with my beliefs as a Christian woman because I was truly able to give myself to this role 100%. This doesn't mean that if you work outside of the home, you cannot give yourself to the role of a homemaker 100%, but for my lifestyle and the busyness of my husband, as well as my personal crosses that I carry, being a childless homemaker at the moment was the best decision. Knowing your why truly gives you the opportunity to grow in this purpose and to continuously develop your skills surrounding whatever your why is. It holds you to a standard of excellence. And excellent is not parallel with burning out, but we always want to achieve more as elegant women, for example. You always want to put your best foot forward, and you can't do that if you are aimlessly going through life without your why. I also want you to understand that the role of a homemaker is so vast. It is not solely surrounded by having kids. If you do have kids, that is your particular season of life that you are in, and you should of course be so invested in nurturing your kids, and the remainder of your life will probably follow. So back to understanding the vast role of the homemaker, she is responsible for creating a warm and nurturing atmosphere. She is of course responsible for whatever tasks you divide up with your husband in terms of like clerical duties, like paying bills, running certain errands, etc. But there's so much work that you can do to create a warm and inviting atmosphere. You can also invest in hosting other people. The opportunities are endless. If you think that homemaking is just about cooking and cleaning, you really are missing out. Engage in other homemaking content on YouTube. The homemaking community has truly grown over the past 5 years, and there are a variety of excellent homemakers out there who are going to help you get in touch with those more deeper aspects of homemaking. The next thing I want to talk to you about is encourage you as a childless homemaker to reframe productivity. Learn about productivity, but understand, like I mentioned in my Q&A, I'm saying that a lot, but go watch the Q&A. That productivity and busyness are two different things. There are so many self-help books, podcasts out there that will help you grow in your productivity, and understand that being continuously busy and continuously stimulated is not the same as getting things done to a high degree of excellence. As a childless homemaker, you really have the opportunity to invest more time in learning these skills that's going to cause you to grow as an individual, because whatever you do in the future, whether kids come into your life or or you go back into the workforce, or you continue to grow your relationship with your husband and you remain a childless homemaker, it's going to give back to you tenfold to establish these skills now while you may be younger, more vivacious, etc. In terms of productivity, I also want you to reframe the way that you're looking at social media. Now, I just said that I want you to engage with other homemakers online and learn from them, but I also want you to understand that social media is a tool and you do not want to be dependent on it. As a childless homemaker, you're doing a lot of lonely work, a lot of work by yourself at home. And it doesn't have to be lonely. You should invest in creating community online or through other homemakers in your area, but you also have to understand that it cannot be attached to comparison. When you have comparison in your life, you're going to go by somebody else's timeline, and you have to go by your own timeline. That's the only way that productivity is going to help you feel more fulfilled. But if you're continuously looking at somebody else's life, you're not going to be able to reach your own milestones and feel satisfaction with that. And since you essentially are your own boss, you have to put in those little mental health pep talks and continuously check in with yourself to make sure that you are not measuring your success in comparison to somebody else's. I'm going to insert a little bit of Christianity here. I was listening to a podcast that I mentioned in my last vlog, so if you want to find out what that podcast is, go to my last vlog, but it had an episode talking about fruitfulness. If you are a Christian woman, I'm not saying this doesn't apply to other faiths, but you know, I do the little caveat and disclaimer that I just don't understand the full picture of other faiths, that's a better way to put it. So I talk from my own personal experience. We are called to be fruitful and multiply, and that does mean having kids. But if you are somebody who cannot have kids, or you are in a situation where kids are just not going to be a part of your future, how can you be fruitful and multiply? So it leads me into my next point, where I want you to consider your passions. You probably have a passion for homemaking if you chose it as your career, but you have this unique opportunity of a couple hours every single day that you can commit yourself to another project. I kind of look at this YouTube channel like my mini ministry apart from my home. This is how I practice fruitfulness and multiply while I'm waiting to have kids. How can you practice fruitfulness and multiply? Maybe it is also a written blog or some sort of online presence, or perhaps it's a community presence. Maybe you can serve on a council, or you can help with a local can drive. Christmas is coming up. I know there are restrictions due to the pandemic, but I'm sure there are other volunteer opportunities that you can focus on. And how can you use your skills to bless other people? You have been given a unique set of skills. You cannot compare your skills to somebody else's skills. You actually have to do the introspection to find out what your actual skills are, and I guarantee there is an extra way that you can be fruitful and multiply those skills to bless other people. So today's video was a little bit short, however I wanted it to serve as encouragement, especially due to the fact that I've gotten a lot of messages from women who are in the same predicament as me or have a different situation, and they kind of feel like they don't belong in the homemaker community because they are childless. But I wanted to end the video by saying that you do belong here. You are important. We do support you, and we want you to be the best homemaker that you can possibly be. Despite whatever circumstance that you have, I want you to feel confident in your life choices and the life that you are living. You aren't in this alone. I support you. The women on this channel support you. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.